Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello friends, welcome to Vastech channel. Today we will see program of MP Lab. The first program is to search a key element in a list of n numbers using binary search algorithm. So, to search a key element in a list of n numbers using binary search algorithm. First we'll see the part of algorithm. So, the part of algorithm is something like this. Initialization. Step one is the initialization, where low is equal to 1 and high is equal to n. And while low is less than equal to high. While low is equal to less than equal to high, we will proceed. Otherwise, when low becomes greater than high, that is not legal condition. There is an illegal condition actually. That time it will come out. While low is equal to less than I, we will try to find out the mid element. If key is equal to, and in the step 3, if key is equal to mid element then key is found. Otherwise, exit. Else, if the key is equal to greater than the mid element, we will search for the element in the upper part of the array, or we will search for the element in the lower part of the array. This is the algorithm. So let me repeat once again. We will initialize low is equal to 1, I is equal to n. While low is equal to, we have to check the condition, while low is equal to high, so this part will take place. Otherwise, when low is greater than I, directly it will go to key not found, because while low is greater than I, that is a illegal condition. While low is equal to less than high, we'll try to find out the mid element and we'll compare the mid element. We'll compare the mid element with the key element, and if the key equal to the mid element, then key is found. There are three cases. Else, key may be greater than the mid element, then we will search the upper part of the array. That time low becomes mid plus 1. Otherwise, we will search the lower part of the array. That time high becomes mid minus 1. So this is the algorithm. So the register we use here, is AX register, and along with the AX register we use a source index register to store mid element. That is because AX we use in between for different purpose, different calculations. So whatever the value you store in AX, it will be lost. So we use source index register to store the mid element. We store low element, low index, I mean low, though this one low in BX register, that is, I am talking about index, low in BX register, and we'll store length in DX register, and we'll store key in CX register. So now, the program part, dot model small. So dot model small indicates memory configuration. Dot model is a assembler directive with the different options are there. Small indicates how many code segments and how many data segments you have used in your memory. Small indicates you have used one code segment of 64 kilobytes and one data segment of 64 kilobytes in your memory. Dot stack is also assembler directive without dot st if you simply write dot stack without any initialization number like this one, without any initialization number, if you just write dot stack, it will default take 1024 bytes of memory, 1024 bytes of memory. Otherwise, in this condition, in this case, we are using dot stack with the 64 bytes of memory is reserved for stack purpose. Dot data is the assembler directive, which indicates data segment, starting of the data segment. So from here onwards, your data segment starts. In the data segment, I will actually use all the datas. I will actually represent all the datas which is used in my program. So initially, I will take one array. Here, ARR is the memory location or name to the memory location. And this array contains 5 elements. You can see here 5 elements. This array is type of data word. That means 16 bits are used to represent each number. That is called as a data word, 16 bits. So to represent 1, 2, 3, 4, I need 16 bits of the memory location. To represent next number, I need 16 bits of the memory location that we will see here. For your information, you will see this one here. So I will take all these number and I will try to show the representation. You can see here the numbers are represented something like this. So this is the memory location. Let us take the memory location start at 000 and 0010. It will end at here. In this case, it will end at 10. Normally this is 00. This should be 0000A. All these representations are in hexadecimal 000A, but for our convenience, I have represented it as 0010. So now the number is stored. If you take this is the lower and this is the higher address. So higher byte is stored in higher and lower byte is stored in lower address. So lower byte is stored in lower address, higher byte is stored in higher address. So that is called as Intel follows little Indian convention. So this is called as little Indian convention. This is where lower byte is stored in lower address and higher byte is stored in higher address. So you can see here, see this is 8 bit. So what I said is memory width is 8 bit, memory address is 16 bit. So this memory is capable of addressing 16 bit, 2 raised to power 16. So you can see 2 raised to power 16 combinations. So here memory width is 8 bit. That means each location can store 8 bit. Means to store word, it need 2 location, like first element, second element, third element, fourth element and fifth element. After inserting all these 5 elements, my pointer is here. My address pointer will be here. So this is the starting location. This is the base location of the base address of the array. This is the end address of the array. This is the end address of the array. This is the base address of the array. After inserting these elements, 5 elements, the pointer is here. Not this, you cannot take this location. You have to take this location because after inserting all these elements, pointer point to the memory location of the next memory location where we need to insert the next element. This one. Clear? Yes. So now we'll go back to our program. So now I will try to find out the length of the array. For that, I will take one memory location. The memory location, I will name it as LEN of type once again word, data word, 16 bit. And I will try to find out length by using formula dollar minus ARR by 2. So let me take you once again to that same slide. Here you can see, in this case you can see, we are using the formula dollar minus ARR. What is dollar in our case here? Dollar is 0010, and base address of the array is 000000 divided by 2. That gives you 5. That indicates 5 elements are there. This is the index. It starts from 1 and end at 11. 5 elements are there. So fine. So now you can see here, so that 5 element is stored in the memory location LEN. That 5 element is stored in memory location LEN. Next, I will use one more memory location. The name of the memory location is key to store immediate value 3456. This element I need to search by using equate operator. So by using equate operator, I will equate 3456 to the memory location name as the key. Then this portion of the code is used to display ASCII value. So for this purpose, I use to display ASCII value. For this purpose, I use following formulas. That is, I use label ASCII 1, ASCII 2, ASCII 3, ASCII 4. ASCII 1 label is equated by this formula, that is key. What is key in our case? In our case, key is 3456. 3456 divided by 1000. It gives somewhere 3.456. You ignore this part. You take this only 3. And for this 3, I will add ASCII value. ASCII value of 0 is 30. Any number which represented is in quote is represents ASCII value. ASCII value of 0 is 30. So ASCII value of 3 is 33. So now by using this one, I represent the ASCII, I display the ASCII value of 3. Now I want 4. So to display 4, what I have to do? So display 4, I will use once again key is 3456. 3456 divided by 100, that gives you 34, ignore decimal part. Then I will apply mod formula to find out the remainder, mod of 10. You know, when you apply mod of 10, you will get remainder 4. So I got 4, right, second digit. And to this, I will add ASCII value 0. ASCII value of 0 is 30. And 4, if you add, you will get ASCII value of 4. ASCII value of 4 is 34. Similarly, here, you will get ASCII value of, in our case, 5. Similar last one is, I am not dividing. I am directly taking mod of 3, 4, 5, 6. What is mod of 3, 4, 5, 6 with mod 10? 3, 4, 5, 6 mod 10. You know, 6 is the remainder, right? If you use 3, 4, 5, 6 with mod 10, 6 is the remainder. For 6, I will add ASCII value. That is, it gives me 36. So this portion is used for displaying ASCII value. Clear? Yes. Now, next, I will take two messages. One is to display not found, other one is to display found. One is to display not found, other one is to display found. Just a second. Yeah, so the first message is not found. So here the name of the memory location is message 1 and message 2 of type DB. So it is a string representation. So you can see a string is represented in quote. That is element here you can see ASCII 1. It will take the value ASCII 2, ASCII 3, ASCII 4. Once again, not found, followed by this one, dollar, termination. And 10 and 13 is used to, this is the decimal value of line field and carriage return. This is the ASCII value in decimal for line field and carriage return. 10 indicates in hexadecimal, it is in hexadecimal, it is A, that is line field, to display result in the next line. Carriage return means to return the carriage to the first column. Line field and carriage return. Carriage return value is 13. In hexadecimal, it is D. In decimal, it is 13. These two values we use. Line field, one is to display the result in the next line, and carriage return the carriage to the first, return the cursor to the first column. You got it right? So yeah, that is the one thing. Message 1. Second one is the message 2, found at the position. Here dollar is not there. You can see here dollar, it is termination. Here dollar is not there. Here dollar is in the string itself. Here dollar is not there. Instead of that, here we are using this is the continuation actually. The continuation of this line is written here actually speaking. Result, again name given to the memory location of type DB and with question mark, not initialized, followed by here result is displayed. Followed by this one, here result is displayed. Clear? Yes. So now, dot code. So always program is, coding part of the program is written in code segment. You can see dot code. Always dot code is end with the end. This is end statement. No other statement is required in between here. Just write dot code followed by last statement is end. So now you can see here dot code. These two statements are initialization statement. What do you mean by initialization? So let me explain initialization. This is the microprocessor. You take, this is the architecture of microprocessor and this is our memory. Microprocessor is interface to memory, right? And memory is divided into different segment. We know memory is divided into code segment, data segment, stack segment and extra segment. At least default this much, extra segment. Here, friends. So this is the architecture. Normally we know I am not using exact pointing device, that's why I am using a mouse, so it is not drawn clearly. Still, this is the execution unit. For time being we are not bothered about it. Bus interface unit. What is there in the bus interface unit of 8086? We have segment register, 16-bit segment registers, right? Bus interface unit will fetch the instruction from a memory. You know, memory is divided into code segment, data segment, stack segment, extra segment. Now, this address, the starting address of the data segment should be moved to the segment register. The starting address of the code segment should be moved to the code segment register. Starting address of the stack segment should be moved to the stack segment register. This is called as initialization. Initialization in the sense, like you have to tell the microprocessor where the code segment starts, where the data segment starts. This is called as initialization. Clear? Yes. Yeah. Now we will move to our program. These two instructions are initialization. What I am doing? I am moving the address of the data segment to AX, and from AX I am moving to data segment register. You cannot move directly to data segment register, address to data segment, address to data segment register. See, this is data segment register, this is data segment, segment address, data segment address. You cannot move it to directly. There a direct movement is not possible. So I move that address to accumulator, from accumulator to data segment. That is called as initialization. Other than that, now we know we have used BX registers to store low, 01, index is 01 here, I will take, and DX length, CX, I will store key element. So this you know. So these are the three instructions. After that, what I do, I will first condition is I will compare BX is DX. You just see here, I will take back to you this one, this stage, just see here. First condition is, according to our algorithm, we have to take check low is equal to less than high. Low is equal to less than high. This is the first condition you have to check. So now what I am doing here is, let me check first whether compare BX. What is there in the BX register? BX register, this is contains low, and this is contains length. Length is nothing but high. I am talking with respect to index. I am not talking with respect to the value of the element. Understood? I am talking with respect to index. This is a low index and this is a high index. So I index is nothing but length, 5. Low is 1. So now first I will check, compare. I will compare first low with high. What compare will do? Compare will subtract source operand from the destination operand, and you will get your result here -4, that is less than 0. When jump above, if the condition, if it is the result is greater than 0, then it is an illegal condition, that is low is greater than high is an illegal condition, then it will go to directly fail, where we display message that is saying key not found, element not found, something like that. So jump above fail, otherwise in this case, in our case, it will proceed. And what I am doing now, I am moving AX, whatever there in the BX, BX contains low to AX, and I will add a DX. Here I am adding accumulator AX, AX contains 1 low element and DX, that is 5. So you will get a 6. How you represent 6 in binary? 0, 1, 1, 0. Now, the second part of my algorithm is I have to find out the mid element. So to find out the mid element, here in assembly language, we use shift right. Normally, shift right, this one will divide the number. Shift left will multiply the number. So if you divide the 6, you will get mid element, right? That's why I will use shift right by 1. So if you right shift this by 1, 1 bit. So I will write completely 8 bit here. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is completely 8 bit. If I shift this one 1, this will go out to the vein or drain. And 1 will come here. This 1 will come here. So followed by 6 zeros. Once again, 1 0 will be added from this end. So now the value got is 3. Clear? You got is 3. That is mid value. So that value I will move into SI. Now my SI is 3. SI is equal to 3. Now I will decrement SI. why I decrement SI? Decrement SI and add SI, SI to get the exact mid element. For this one, I will take you to once again. Once again, to diagram this one. So, the SI value I got here is 3. After that, I will use a decrement SI. Decrement SI will give me 2. Decrement SI will give me 2 here. Then add SI, SI. Add SI, SI. So SI, SI. That means I will add SI with SI. And the final result is stored here. That is 2 plus 2. I will add 2 plus 2. And final result is stored in a SI. That is, I will get 4. That is, first memory location will end here. Second, third, fourth end here. So my mid element, it will indicate the starting of the mid element. Not this one. Pointer, next pointer. It is the starting of the mid element. So this is our mid element, right? Yes or no? Right. Yeah. Clear. So once again, I will take back to program. So now you know SI is equal to 4. Now compare key with the 4. Now compare the key. Key is stored in CXI with the, compare the key with the fourth element of the array. See, it is ARR 4. ARR 4. Compare key. What is key element? You see in our program. What is key element in our program? Key element is 3, 4, 5, 6. You compare this one with the mid element. So you compare this one with the mid element. Mid element is 2, 3, 4, 5. Fourth element in the array. 2, 3, 4, 5 is the mid element. You compare this one with this one. So here you can see when I write this command, this array, so it is indirect mode. See, it is indirect mode, not direct mode, indirect mode, register indirect mode actually. So here I am giving index, fourth element of this array. What is fourth element? You saw that. What is key? You saw that. So key is equal to, in our case key is 3, 4, 5, 6, and mid element is 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now, if it is jump above or equal big, that means, if the result is greater than 0, or equal. Sometimes, you take the key is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, and assume mid element is also 2, 3, 4, 5. You have taken the key 2, 3, 4, 5, and the mid element is also 2, 3, 4, 5. Then both are equal, right? This condition also exists. But now in this case, no. In our case, our key element is 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, both condition, it will jump to big. That means, I want to tell, suppose this is the mid element. You think this is the mid element. And key is here. Key is somewhere here. This is the key. So, if this result is greater, then jump to this part, big, upper part, or jump to lower part. When it jump to upper part, your I will not change, your low will change from mid to mid plus 1. Mid to mid plus 1. Low will change to mid plus 1. Clear? When you jump to the lower part, low will not change. I will change. The value of I, index I am talking. I am not talking the value of the element. I will change to mid minus 1. This thing you have to remember. these changes we are doing. See here. You see here, jump above or equal. That is, your key is here and mid element is here. That means jump above or equal. Then you are the control is transferring to this one big, say label big. That we'll see. Otherwise, you have to search here. When you search here, your I becomes a change. Your low will not become change. I become change. So what you do? I value decrement AX. I value AX contains now mid. You know, AX contains mid. You decrement that one and move that one to DX. You know, DX contains high value, right? DX contains a high value. You got my point, I believe. Now, why we are decrementing AX? AX contains mid element. Of course, AX contains mid element. That I decrement it by 1 and I will pass that into DX register. I will pass that into DX registers. Clear? Yes. So, after that, I will once again repeat the loop. Jump again. And I will check for the element in the lower part. Otherwise, in big, what is there? There are two conditions. In big, two conditions. As I said here, if the key is somewhere here, this is the mid element. If the key is somewhere here, what you have to do? Your I will not change. Your low will change. Low will change to mid plus 1. So, mid element is there in AX. Mid element is there in AX. So, increment AX, that is you make low is equal to I plus 1, low is equal to mid plus 1, then move the mid element into BX register because our BX register contains a mid element, then jump to again. Here two condition I said, I told that time, suppose your key and mid element both are same, then directly found, success. So directly element is found. How to display now? So mid element is there in AL or key that is the position is there in AL. You display the ASCII value. How you display the ASCII value? You add ASCII character 0 to this one. That is the ASCII value of 0, 30. 30 is added to the AL. Suppose AL is 3, 30 is added, you will get 33. That is position element found at the position 3 and whose ASCII value is 33. Move that to the result location and display the message. So message 2 has to be displayed. To display the message, what you have to do? You have to move the effective address of the message in the DX register. Effective address of the message in the DX register and jump to display section. In the display section, I will call interrupt 21HI with the DOS function 09 to display. First, address is moved to DX. You cannot use any other register here. You have to use DX register only. Address is moved. Then call interrupt with the 29, interrupt 21 with the DOS function 09. Here also you have to use AH only. Please remember. Then I will call interrupt 21H with 4CH to terminate the program. This is for message 2 to display. Otherwise, if everything fails, it will come here and it will take message 1's address value, that is fail condition in DX register, and it will proceed like this. So this is the program. This is the program to find position of the element in a binary search. Here elements are listed in sorted order. So you'll get result something like this, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how to execute this program? Execute this program is write the program by using editor. Write the program by using editor first, then assemble it by using MASM, then assemble it by using MASM, then link it by using link program. Then directly execute it. Don't use a debug, AF debug, because if you want to see the message, that time you can see element 3, 4, 5, 6 found at position 4. Then after that, you change the element. change the element. For example, you change the element 3, 4, 5, 6. You change this key value, which is not here. You change this value. You give different value. We should not be here. That time you should get the second message, message not found. So this is the display. So please go through it. Any doubt you can write me or text me or message me. Thank you.